Hey guys, what's up? I'm Mark, and in this channel, I talk a bit about lifestyle and a lot about personal finance and investments. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you this one seemingly insignificant detail about the Gotrade app, which might ultimately make you choose it over eToro or other trading platforms. This detail is something that we probably gloss over in the past and something that we didn't really consider. But let me tell you, this detail is big enough for me to consider using Gotrade more and maybe the eToro platform a little bit less. So what's this one feature that I'm talking about? Well, before anything, this isn't going to be another detailed review of the Gotrade app. I already have two of those. Check out my previous videos on that. But for today's video, let's get on with the meat of the matter and really start talking about what this one specific thing that is really working in favor of the Gotrade app. This detail that tips the scale to Gotrade from eToro would be its foreign exchange rate. By how much, do you ask? So here are the numbers. I did quite a bit of experimenting, and take note, all of this was done on the 9th of November. So if you wanted to cross-reference, please feel free to do so. Bear with me here, we're going to be working quite a bit with numbers in this video. This just has to do with your money, so I know you're going to pay attention even if it might be a little difficult. So I tried to see what the difference would be in terms of exchanging your peso to dollars in the different platforms. So let's start with Gotrade. In Gotrade, you actually have two different deposit options. The first would be an instant deposit, which means exactly that. The money will be credited to your account right away. And for the deferred deposit, this means that you'd have to wait 24 hours before your account gets credited. So I explored depositing $5 into my Gotrade account. With the instant deposit feature, my $5 would be 254 pesos or an exchange rate of 50.8 pesos to $1. While for the 24-hour deferred deposit, my $5 would be 253 pesos or an exchange rate of 50.6 pesos. Now let's move on to eToro. The weird thing about eToro was that previously, you could actually do a bank deposit via eToro, but in the last few months, they actually deactivated this feature. So I hope this is temporary because the only options now for depositing to your eToro account would be either via PayPal or your credit or debit card. Now, of course, that's a feature in itself, but the thing with working with PayPal or credit or debit cards would actually be a higher foreign exchange rate. In eToro, you actually can't deposit just $5. You actually have to put in a lot more, especially when you just newly opened your account. So for purpose of uniformity, I actually charge $5 to my BPI credit card. But since I couldn't do this in eToro, I actually had to find somewhere else where I could charge $5 in the same date. So to do this experiment, I actually charge $5 into my Skype account. So checking my BPI statement, the $5 charged by Skype to me amounts to 256 pesos and 94 centavos, meaning that the exchange rate is actually 51 pesos and 39 centavos to $1. So comparing the foreign exchange rate of my BPI credit card to my deposit via Gotrade, the foreign exchange rate of 51.39 versus 50.8 when I deposited into Gotrade. So the difference is actually 1.15%. Now, I know that's not much and you could probably shrug it off, but remember, this is just in the deposit. There is still half a battle when we withdraw this money. And if you actually want to compare the deferred deposit feature that I mentioned earlier, the difference would be 1.56%. So yep, you're starting to feel it, right? Okay, so let's move on to withdrawing this money. This is where it gets a little bit more interesting. So for Gotrade, the peso to dollar conversion would be 49 pesos and 43 centavos to $1. Again, keep that number in mind. In eToro, they removed some of the withdrawing features and options as well. Previously, you could withdraw directly into your bank account.
On second look, there's an option to do a withdrawal into your bank account, but there is a disclaimer that this method is not guaranteed, so it's definitely not an option they're pushing.
The option that they were giving me before was that my credit card would be credited whatever withdrawals I get, so it would be a reversal on my card. But currently, the only option to withdraw from eToro would be via a PayPal account. Now, this is a problem because PayPal is notorious for having exorbitant exchange fees. For eToro via PayPal, the exchange rate is actually 48 pesos and 48 centavos to $1. So going back, that's 49 pesos and 43 centavos for Gotrade and just 48 pesos and 48 centavos for eToro via PayPal. So the difference here between Gotrade and eToro is actually 1.9%. when you deposit to Gotrade versus eToro, your money is actually worth 1.15% more. And when you withdraw your money is actually worth 1.9% more than it would have been in eToro. So that actually amounts to over 3%. Meaning if you took on the same position, you bought and sold the same stock identically in eToro and Gotrade, your yields in eToro would be 3% less. So you have to do a much better job in your trades in eToro than Gotrade. And for some of you watching, maybe 3% is not all that much, but 3% is 3%. I mean, if you deposited $1,000, 3% is $30. That's still 1,500 pesos. For me, that's something, that's a sizable amount. So definitely your pesos are worth more in Gotrade than they are in eToro. So that's sort of a horizontal comparison between Gotrade and eToro in terms of deposit and withdrawal. But if you were to look at it vertically, in Gotrade, what you actually lose when you deposit and when you withdraw, the whole cycle costs you 2.7% of your money. While in eToro, what you actually lose in that entire cycle is 5.6%. That's actually double your losses already from Gotrade. So again, your position in eToro should do much, much better than Gotrade because the foreign exchange rate is just unforgiving. To be completely transparent and to expose the fees related to Gotrade and eToro, the good thing about eToro is that your deposits are free. Of course, the minimum at eToro is much higher at $50. For Gotrade, the minimum deposit is just $1, but they do have a deposit fee depending on the bank that you're working with. So for GCash, it's actually 3%. For BPI, it's at 12 pesos. And what I personally use is Union Bank, which has the lowest fees at 10 pesos. So computing for this, you would actually have to deposit at least $30 so that the 10 peso deposit fee still comes out lower than your deposit via eToro. And for the withdrawal, the fees in Gotrade are actually at $4, while in eToro, it's $5. So since these fees are at a flat rate, the more you withdraw, the less it will actually impact your percentages. You're actually gonna come out on top with Gotrade more. Your investments and trade positions don't have to be as stellar because in eToro, you're just working with so much of the fees that you have to recuperate. And so I hope this little bit of information has been useful for you. With these fees, do you think Gotrade is so much more worth it now than eToro? Or are you still sticking with eToro because there are just so much more features that you can work with? For me personally, I'm keeping both. I still have my positions on eToro. I guess eToro would be more for my commodities, my Forex and crypto. I think I'm going to be using Gotrade more for my global stocks. Again, both apps, both platforms have their pros and cons. If you're not yet on eToro or Gotrade, you can click on my links below. For Gotrade, you can get $2 free when you sign up. Just make sure you use my referral code
998839. That's 998839.
If you've liked this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and consider subscribing if you haven't already. Thanks again for watching, guys, and happy investing.